Yeah, literally, what did you...
I mean, 2014, guys, come on.
Straight up, now tell me, do you really want to love me forever? Oh. Or is it just a hit and run? Hey, we got a good thing. Don't know if I'ma see you again.
Not on my record button. I'm a professional, I guess. Tilt it up. Oh, shit. You gonna focus on me a little? Bitch, hurry up. Is this angle flattering or am I losing it? This angle isn't that flattering, but it is what it is. Hi, friends. It's Amber. Today, we're going to be unboxing the One Direction. It's actually not even considered unboxing. First of all, there's dust. Don't know if you'll be able to see that. No, it's not gonna focus. My camera gonna take forever to focus. There's dust on here. I'm gonna see if I can like. Ew. Oh my, you gonna see this dust. I did not put dust on my finger for you to not see. There it is. We're doing major renovations in my, okay. We're doing major renovations in my house, right? And I stay downstairs. I stay on the bottom half of my house and my folks stay upstairs. We're like 80% done with the downstairs. And my bathroom was something that, you know, we had to take apart and all this other stuff, right? And this was in there. And I'm not gonna sit here in front and make it seem like I didn't know what was up in there. I knew what was up in there, but I just never composed myself to get rid of it. I just never pushed myself to like throw it away. Okay, let me tell you the background story it is. Actually, I wanted to look up when One Direction even put out this makeup kit because the moment they, you like, talked about it and I was like, oh my gosh, it's gonna be in America, I'm definitely gonna get me one because all One Direction stans should have One Direction makeup, right? No, I was completely wrong, 100%. I don't know what I was thinking, but, Why did this pop up talking about who is the ugliest One Direction member? What did they say? It's fucked up. I'm not gonna tell y'all who they say it, but it's fucked up. Yeah, it came out in 2014, I believe. I was never a makeup person. I'm still not a makeup person, like, at all. I'm trying to train myself to be a makeup person, but I'm not one. You know what I'm saying? Sorry, gotta be dramatic. And when you think about it, I don't know why I bought One Direction makeup when I know I'm not a makeup person, when I know I can't do makeup, but, I mean, One Direction stan things, I guess. This is it. And I put the makeup on once and I played around in it. I remember it. I made a video about it, but it was long deleted. And I think I still have pictures on my old computer. If I could find those pictures, I'll show you because I was literally just fucking around with it. I don't know why, but I was. Here we had the notorious purple mascara. I'm a Barbie. I'm a Barbie. I'm the Barbie that got left in the factory. I mean, granted, homegirl had a good time. But even at the time, I knew that this makeup was not made for fans like me. It just wasn't. Not even just the black fans, but like the fans with darker skin and stuff like that felt so unincluded. And mainly, I don't know if any of y'all remember, but there was the big fiasco that happened with the Night Changes music video. For anybody who doesn't know, in the Night Changes music video, you know, it was supposed to be a POV where, oh my gosh, we're on a date with all five guys. However, they continuously would show the skin of the POV girl and she was white. So naturally, a lot of people who either weren't white or didn't have that skin color felt some kind of way about that. I mean, and all for it, because I was one of those people. I was like, well, how am I supposed to have a POV when my hand is white? That's not fair. You know, that's not cool. I honestly think I still have the music video up where I reacted to it, actually. I'll link it down below. It's old. I don't even know if it's... But I do remember talking about it, especially because I was a really big advocate on black directioners, and my Instagram fan page was real based on black directioners, and I was one of the first, like, really big black directioner pages where people was like, oh my gosh, there's another black person that likes One Direction. You know, it was real taboo. Y'all know, y'all get it. We did like a protest, not a protest, we did something where we did like this hashtag where we was like, why aren't we included and all this other stuff. And the motherfucker who did it, I think it was Ben Winston, his racist ass, had said something to us. He said, well, that's too bad. Y'all gonna have to deal with it, blah, 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 blah. It was really hurtful, especially considering the fact that one of the guys in the band is brown. Like, did he have a say in that? Did he have a say in this? Did they have a say in this? I don't know. I genuinely feel like One Direction, because, you know, I was a fan of a lot of different people, of One Direction, the Jonas Brothers, Justin Bieber, you know, of like a lot of pop music that were predominantly white people. And I always felt like they didn't believe that they had black fans. Like, I think they were like, oh yeah, of course I have black fans. Why wouldn't I? But I don't think they thought we were as big as we were. There were a lot of black directioners I found, and that found me. And it was insane, but it was so beautiful. But we didn't feel included, you know? We were like the 5% of everything else, you know? Anyway, I'm going deep. That wasn't even the plan, but I will talk about that at some point, about, you know, a lot of different things. But we're gonna open it. This is gonna be my first time opening it since the day I bought it. So, wow, I really just thought about that. It's been in my, wow, it's been in my bathroom closet since 2014. That's actually kind of nasty. Okay, I don't know how I'm gonna set this up. I'm gonna set this up so that y'all can kind of see me open it. Y'all ain't gonna be able to see that. I'm gonna see if I can get y'all up on this chair. Fuck it, I'm gonna just show y'all just like this, okay? It came with all the little stickers and everything, and I have put the stickers like that. Makeup by One Direction face mask. Okay, here we go. Oh my. Interesting. Oh, it's a foldy, ain't it? Oh, all right. Oh, that's all broke. First thing we can talk about is this. Not gonna lie, these colors slap. I don't know if they're any good. Let me, you know, Okay, not bad. Okay, what are the names? Oh, these are just regular basic ass names. I don't know why I thought one was gonna be, you know, Nando's or some cringy ass shit. I guess this was a liner. What was this? I can't see that. I think it was a liner, but damn, I used the hell out of that. For what? Oh, well, I used to, trust me, I don't know how to use liner, so I definitely use that for some plain shit. I guess this is some silver liner? That's interesting. Okay. And then we have, I remember this, the Notorious Purple Mascara. Get your happy ass out this. I don't know whose idea it was to get purple mascara. I mean, nothing against purple mascara, but I feel like at the time, everybody was like, purple mascara, you know, like, what? Ew. Oh, yeah, that's definitely dried out. Happy that they didn't have, like, foundation and stuff like that, so at least they allowed you to do that for yourself. They had nail polish, which I think is interesting, because this is supposed to be a makeup kit, not, not a pamper yourself kit, so. That's interesting. Okay, there's some lip gloss all the way in there that I can't get. This is a glitter. Oh. 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 Oh, wow. That's kind of cool. I fuck with glitter. Wish it wasn't pink, but you know what I'm saying? Beggars can't be choosers. I don't know what this is. A keychain? Is it? Am I supposed to hold the box on this? Put it around my neck? What is this for? What is this? A light? Is this a light? For what? Anyway. So, I'm not even gonna sit here in front and lie to y'all, okay? It's not as bad as I remember, which is some good shit. The only thing that, you know, well, there aren't a lot of neutral colors for the eyeshadow, so that's a little concerning. For people who are darker skinned than me, but you know, it was a different time. At the time, you know what I'm saying? People who are darker skinned than me can real life rock some bright ass colors, you know what I'm saying? But at the time being, I feel like a lot of us felt like we couldn't. I know I did. I know I did. And I was like, I can't put this yellow on, this bright ass yellow, this bright ass lime green, this orange. I can't do that. Like, it's not gonna look good on me. I bet y'all could rock that motherfucker today, but that was all the self-esteem talking. But what I do remember that wasn't made for darker skinned people was the lip swatches. Because when I put on the pink one, bro, when I put on the red one, it was like, what is this? Now, honestly, I don't know how it's going to look now. I kind of want to try it and see. Well, actually, it's pretty old, so I don't know. I never knew what these pencils were. Is that supposed to outline my lips? Why? For what? So this is what we have, right? So I wiped off my lip gloss. Which one should we try first? We should go for the Notorious Pink. Am I supposed to outline my lips with this? I'm confused. Am I even doing this right? I told you I'm not good at makeup. Oh my. Can y'all see that? Is this like supposed to be on the outliner of it? Oh, wait a minute. I don't know why I thought this part was like lipstick. So I'm supposed to outline it and then I use this, but this is like orange. Is that gonna match? Do this. Let me see if this ugly ass shit is supposed to. It smells like Play-Doh. Y'all know how old this is. Make sure I don't get nothing in my mouth. I don't understand. Is that literally what it? I mean, 2014, guys, come on. Alrighty then. I'm going to show y'all what I look like on my Snapchat. So this is what I look like on my Snapchat. And I mean, it's not for me. It doesn't look bad, but it wouldn't be something that I would like take. You know what I mean? It looked a lot worse when I was coming up, you know, and honestly, a lot of it could have just been blamed on the fact that I didn't know how to do makeup. But I do remember a lot of Black Directioners specifically complaining about it. So that's why I wanted to relive it and see what's up. And it's got a cute little shimmer. Look at that. Okay. So that's what it looked like. I guess. Like, see, look, I feel like... Oh, no. Oh no, maybe because it doesn't go with my eyeshadow, but it's like, I feel like I look like a hoe that's on TV shows, like the hooker that's on TV shows, you know what I'm saying? That's how I feel like I look. No offense to anybody who out there doing that, I mean, babe, do you, but I'm saying this is how I feel like I look, like from some real old show, like, no. And I can't even test the lip gloss. See, okay, see, it's got a little tint, and that's fine. That's kind of cute. But, like, it looks different on my Snapchat. It doesn't look bad on my Snapchat, but when I looked in the camera, I was like, everything's just falling apart. I was like, no. So now we're going to try the red. I remember the red made me feel like, you know, it was on some racist shit. I ain't even gonna lie to you. That sure how made me feel. Kind of look the same. It kind of look just like the pink one. Since I can't use lip gloss, I'm just gonna try to fill my lips in. Again, not as bad as I remember, but still not good. It's like, I don't know. Like from back here, I'm just, you know, I feel like the red goes more with kind of what my little rocker vibe that I have today, but it's still, you know, it's still kind of overpowering to me. I mean, it looks good. I mean, it looks good on my skin. It's not anything like what I remember. I feel like I liked it, the pink one in my Snapchat, better than the red one. But, I mean, it's like a good little lip tint. It's like a cute little lip tint, I guess. I don't know. I never had a lip tint. But, like, occasionally I feel like I look like an ant, even though I am an ant. But I feel like I look like the ant that can be a cool ant, but it's trying too hard to be a cool ant, if that makes sense. Maybe I could add some of my own lip gloss to it. Maybe that'll up her up a notch. Who knows, right? Mmm. It's not super duper bad, I guess. Anyways, you guys, that was me retesting the One Direction thing. I'm going to keep the eyeshadows, but everything else is getting trashed. I'm going to keep the eyeshadow and I'm going to keep the glitter, but everything else is getting trashed for sure. I don't know, because now I'm still kind of debating. Well, no, because these are old. I ain't even gonna play myself with that. But it's nothing like too bad. It's really not as bad as I remember. And it really, like how I talked it up in the beginning of the video made it seem like it was gonna be really, really bad. But again, I remember a lot of dark-skinned directioners and mainly black directioners being upset about this because they just felt like, you know, it just didn't go with their skin. You know, it felt like it was just leveled out for people of lighter skin. And even though I'm going to keep the eyeshadows, I still can see that because there's no warm tones. Like, there's one warm tone. There's one little, what is this? I don't know what that is right here. It's kind of like matte a little bit. So I don't know if these are lip glosses or if these are supposed to substitute. I don't know. But they didn't highlight it, so it ain't that important to them. I just wanted to relook at it just to throw back and experience it again and see, you know, was it really as bad as I remember? I can wholeheartedly say that I was very dramatic coming up, but my feelings are very valid. And although I know I'm still dramatic, but clearly not as dramatic as I was back then, I know that the makeup kit hurt my feelings because I felt like it didn't make me feel pretty. Whenever I saw that other people kind of felt that way, I was like, you know, there it is again, y'all not realizing that there are other races, you know, in your fandom and everything like that. So, but you know, looking at it now, it's not that bad, but it's still, everything's just falling apart, huh? It's not that bad, but it's still doesn't seem like it is for, you know, it could be for any kind of skin color, I guess is what I'm saying. Because, you know, the way the lipstick looks on you, it looks different on me, and it looks different on people darker than me, and so on and so forth. So, you know, it was just, you know, and they don't wear makeup, so maybe it was a little far-fetched for them to make a makeup kit. I don't know. 2014 and 2020 are two completely different places on earth, like period. And if they came out with makeup right now, I have high expectations of them coming out with something that's good for all races in their fandoms, period. But yeah, so much for being on the journey with me and for looking through it, because that was very interesting. I mean, everything's old and falling apart and whatever, but you know, it was still fun and entertaining. So I'm gonna throw away the box. I don't need the box. I'm literally just keeping the eyeshadow and the glitter. That's it. My birthday is on the 10th. Woohoo! So feel free to follow me on Instagram if you want to, because I'm gonna be posting birthday pics. So you can follow me on Instagram if you want to. It's always down below. My Twitter is AmbotSours, and I just got a TikTok. Yay! But you know, I'm funny, so. And my TikTok is AmbotSours as well, and I'll just have all that linked down below. My Snapchat, everything, you know. If you ever want to keep up to date with me, the best way to keep up to date with me is my Snapchat, because I post on Snapchat all the time, and you just always know, hey, she's alive, you know what I mean? But thank you guys so much for watching. I really appreciate it. To anybody who has a One Direction box, tell me what you think. Like, did you like it coming up? Do you still like it? Would you still bite? If it came out today and it looked it like this, it had this palette, it had these nail polishes, the glitter, the lip tints, would you buy it? Like, genuinely, would you buy it? Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you have an awesome day, an amazing day. And I will surely see you all next time. Remember, keep your head up and smile, and always remember that somebody has your back. Bye, guys.